Greetings, space friends, and welcome back to Let's Play Aurora for X United Union of Youth. We continue on our cosmic journey. You spread peace and enlightenment by whatever means necessary. Advanced time about 4 months. Mostly that was just colony organization and that sort of thing. We have three new jump points found in the Canberra system. Birds could be a fairly decent long haul. Thankfully, we have a ship ready to make that haul. And already scout frigates. Fernando Cortez, which I believe was a Californian senator. Dusarna. Canberra. And just go ahead and make a standard transit. Let's go ahead and look at the class here. So. And fairly standard, has a point defense system and 4 anti-ship missiles. So, it's not a great ship, but it's not really expected to survive. Just supposed to find the enemy and maybe get a little shot in. Reload rate 5. So launchers 4. Okay. Just gonna get the launcher techs out of the way. Might not even use all of these. This is the full size rapid fire one. There's a scenario or two where that might come in handy. And we want 75, which is what we normally use. No improvement for PDCs. Normally I go to size 8 for cruiser missiles, but size 6 for cruiser missiles. I'm going to play around with size 8 for this play. So. Got a few ideas. This is the P8 PDC version. Pretty ship version. Full size. I'm gonna make. I'm not planning to use it, but I'll make it. It's only 600 research points, which at this point in the game doesn't really matter. Really, just an afterthought. That's done. 75. I'll do a 50 for this one. Okay, and go ahead and just queue all those up. And these new launchers will go into our next generation ships. We're not going to incorporate them into the 6,000 speed ships. So the two ship types are going to be working separately in under most situations. Do I want that? We really need to get our missiles going. I can always switch back later. Okay, no, that's taken care of. Okay, next advanced time. Thousand tons of thorium found on the Xenos. That is a big deal. Research lab at Capal looks like it's got shipped over. Would stock up the 37. Oh, where's that 20? We could even move another lab. And we still have no defensive specialists, which is kind of annoying. Dropping a few tracking stations on this moon. We have a lot of ships transiting for that system, so it's a thought. Okay, but where is Gladius A3? It's a terraformable world with no minerals found, so that's going to be our... If we can find something, that's going to really that's going to alter our colonization plans this way. You can see we got already have the full spectrum of minerals in Concordia in the Gladius system. So, this is going to be another base. Also, we were able to do a ground survey of all the B and C components. Oh, that's nice. It's a bit of a hell world, though. Never. I like the mine worlds like this, but so many planets, so many rocks, so few mines. Oh, this is a nice one here. Where is this? Deuteronium, sorry, and Gallicite. You get our name. Okay, that's time. Terraformer over Hogworks. Little turtle scrapped. Served us well. Let's check the Tegger's Eye. One or two are actually doing things. It's still overhauling, and one should be on his way back. Still serving. Still good, still good. Okay. She got a lot of ships just kind of sitting there. So, kind of acting as a reserve. don't have any freighters sitting around. There we are. Okay. Let's crack open our stockpiles. First, we can scrap. Very selectively scrap the parts of the old ships that we're not using. I think we're still using these parts. I'm going to leave that for now. Still using those launchers for sure. Okay. Now we got these four gauss cannons. Disassemble. I'm going to check the messages, see what we get. Tech data learned. So we get gauss cannon rate of fire, gauss cannon velocity. That's why you wanted to transfer it over to. And technology like that, the partial techs, full techs are empire wide, partial techs are system. So you do want to be a bit selective there. So. Like shields and that, we would transfer over to. Hogwarts to disassemble there, but we got a bit of tech there. So if we go over to missiles kinetic, you can see our partial tech on the gauze. And so we got about 1,000 in velocity and 3,000 in rate and fire, which is pretty really the important one in most situations. 9 auto mines and chakra. I'm gonna grab 4 auto mines from you. And a mass driver. Okay. Drop that off on Neverland. The other 5 is gonna dump on Venus. Time. Modified. Shortage being dealt with. Yeah, nothing exciting there. Blue Jay system. What have we got here? Looks empty. That's empty. That's empty. That's empty. So there's nothing in here. Cortez. How's the fuel status? 78. Transit and just jump to the next system. Okay. Factory sword, 10 times salvage module, 1,000. Still worth, definitely worth picking up there. One inactive lab on Earth. Okay, and I'm gonna put that 65 and power propulsion. Gotta use that. Crazy. I'm gonna go over to the resources. I'm gonna load the automated mines, which aren't being used. Jump over to, back to Gladius and drop them off on good times, which is a mining site. Then head back to Earth and refuel. Do need to remember those salvage modules are there. They are probably worth grabbing, but I don't know. Athens. Can see at least one planet, so might have something here. A gas giant, dwarf planet with a moon. A little something on the B component, but can we get to it? That's the question. You can pull this pretty far away. Ah, 75 fuel, I don't know if you can do that. I'm gonna keep an eye on it. Jump point found the Gladius system. Probably want to get our defenses up a little in that system before we go for those jump points. Thank you. check the fuel of the Port Cortez. 67. I don't know if you're going to be able to make it. No, you're not going to have the fuel. So abort mission to head home. Stop training. Okay. Get you set up. So let's adjust the map. Very promising world, but that's really quite far away. Over to back to Athens then. $20 billion. It's about the same distance between Avalon A and B. Site stored. Five automated mines. Let's grab a. Let's grab a Tychert. Relatively short run. Tanif. Unload Zenos. Actually, you know what? We could do this. Grab surface ship. I think we're gonna send him to the nebula, to be honest. That's why we gave him an extra layer of armor, so go ahead and do that. Get in there. Finish the survey. One thing we could do, I haven't been doing. Commands. Right now we have a range of 2. We need a range of 3. So that means we need to build 2 more of these facilities. What's the total? Just expanding our shipyards because we can do that. So there's not too much population for it. Pretty sure we're good. Yeah, we're good. Oh, what do we got here? What have we got here? New race contact in Sarna. Oh crap. Okay. This makes things a bit more interesting. Squadron is ready to sortie. Move to bird. Just sit on the jump point for now. And I think we're just gonna open negotiations on how to educate them. Means we probably should start. Let's lay down a couple of ships just as a. This is a bit of a precaution here. Yeah, that's reasonable. We can get a laser corvette as well. Have this Cortez moving. I'm gonna have the Cortez just move the intercept. Just see if we can get a close look at it. Okay. Contacts. Follow. So we have a huge speed advantage right now. That's probably just like a survey ship. Yeah, just head home for now. It's a geo survey ship, that's what it is. Tell by the way it's acting. So we have at least one engine tech on these guys. Probably two or three. Nico Blue 8. Okay, what are you loaded with? Look at the map here. Contact is in Sarna here, which cuts off our connection to Copenhagen. Bird is our, which Novaterra is a okay, so it's fairly far away from our colonies. So we might need to put a colonial defense base on Novaterra, but that's not really going to do much for us. So we do need to... Start missile production, because you never know. Never knows he's unidentified creatures. Identifies the Republic of Rijevac. Okay. So we can negotiate with these creatures, and they are crew neutral at this point, at least for now. Water is just sitting on the jump point. Over to them. Have a rainbow sky. I just have one ship with the sensors on. Just kind of sitting there. You never know. Active grav sensor strength 36. So, just want something quick right now. Interesting. Could do that. Yeah, I'll just do that for now. Put that on. Back down to 10. You know what? I'm gonna strip everything down. I'm gonna focus. Everything on engines at this point. Let's get that. That'll make maximum use of the scientist while he's still alive. You know, take that down to 5 there. And that's going to be an episode. Well, we've found some very interesting creatures, so hopefully they can be persuaded to join the Unity, but they do not appear to be particularly hostile, so possibly we can reason with them. If not, well, we'll just have to show them their other ways. Anyway, stay groovy, groovy space people. Wolf person out.